It's a horror scenario for most of us. Our mobile phone getting stolen. OK, at least the data's safe, thanks to the PIN and the fingerprint sensor. Or that's what you'd expect. Trouble is, fingerprint sensors often have dangerous vulnerabilities. Spoofing is the name given to outsmarting the sensors. And it's much easier than you think. And when it comes to spoofing, these two men know all the tricks. Bao Pi and Yi He work for the Chinese company Shenzhen Goodix. Pi is the chief technology officer. He is the chief developer. Together, they've declared war on data theft. Fingerprint sensors were first installed in smartphones in 2013 and soon became popular all over the world. We began to investigate the conventional sensors and found that the technology posed enormous safety risks. A fingerprint consists of a unique pattern of grooves and ridges. Conventional sensors decode this pattern using what is called electrical capacitance. These capacitive sensors incorporate a fine grid placed under a low electrical charge. When you place your finger on the surface of the sensor, the charge changes at the points where any mound in the skin is detected. These differences in charge reconstruct the fingerprint. The problem is that fingerprints that have been printed with conductive ink can quickly fool the existing technology. Fingerprints pressed with waxy materials can also easily fool the sensors. Far too easy. Our goal was, therefore, to develop a sensor that eliminates all these hidden dangers. The two inventors have an idea. If the sensor could detect whether the fingerprint were alive, it would know that there was a real person behind it. Their first approach, check the pulse. For this purpose, an LED emits infrared light that penetrates the skin and is reflected back. The heartbeat changes the reflection. Infrared light detection of heart rate can actually work effectively. The problem is that it's relatively slow. The normal heart rate is 60 to 80 beats per minute. This means that you would have to press your finger on the sensor for longer than 1 second. And in the world of the two inventors, 1 second lasts an eternity. Yi He has spent many years researching optical sensors, including LiDAR radar systems. This knowledge now paves the way for a completely new approach based on the principle of so-called spectral reflectivity. Blood flows through our fingers. When light shines through the finger, its reflection has a very specific frequency spectrum. For example, red, green, and blue. With increasing pressure, this reflection spectrum changes. This is a key feature that distinguishes a real finger from a fake finger. He and Pi do tests, analyzing in detail how the color spectrum of reflected infrared light changes when a finger with blood is pressed on the sensor. This becomes the basis of their tamper-proof sensors. They now use two principles. A capacitive sensor recognizes the fingerprint's pattern, and an LED shines infrared radiation through the finger. An optical sensor analyzes the reflection of this and can determine from its pattern whether it's a living finger. And all this happens within a fraction of a second. It takes them 2 years to get from the idea to the production-ready module. While Pi and He develop the technology, their colleagues bring the prototypes to series maturity. And from 2015 onwards, they license them to manufacturers of smartphones and smart home systems. Thanks to this, their technology is now used around the globe. And the basis for this success? Patents. This is especially important for us because our sensors are manufactured by authorized third-party companies. That's why we have to share all technical details with them. And patents are the only way to protect our technology. Bopi and Yihe are constantly developing their sensors further. Their invention is today installed in many smartphone models of various brands. It's a fantastic feeling to know that over a billion people use our technology every day to protect their privacy and secure their property. It's a really great sense of achievement for our engineers. And that not only makes the two inventors happy, it helps all of us as well.